The next construct that we will discuss is the Energy Imbalance Market construct. This construct has been used in the Eastern Connection and is currently becoming more prominent in the Western Interconnection. With an energy imbalance market, the underlying bilateral market construct remains, but an extra layer is added to allow the market operator to adjust for the differences between scheduled production and usage and actual production or usage in real time using security-constrained economic dispatch. Energy imbalance, or EI, is the difference between what actually happens for each generator and load location and what was prearranged through schedules. Energy imbalance occurs when generators produce amounts of energy that are different than what they have scheduled, or loads consume amounts of energy that are different than what they have scheduled. When this occurs in an energy imbalance market, the market operator directs resources that have opted to participate in the market through Security Constrained Economic Dispatch, or SCED, so that the most economical generator is backed down or ramped up to account for the energy imbalance. While the concept of energy imbalance is simple, the application within an energy imbalance market is slightly more complex. In the EIM, there are still balancing authorities, and each balancing authority is still responsible for balancing the load, generation, and interchange within their balancing authority area. The difference between a normal bilateral market and an energy imbalance market construct is that the differences in generation and load in real time between what is scheduled and actual is served by the market operator utilizing advanced market systems to dispatch the lowest cost resource to serve those differences in real time. This construct leverages resource and geographic diversity to more economically serve both obligations and imbalance across a large footprint. Asset owners benefit from this construct by pooling their resources and gaining access to lower, more transparent pricing. Generator owners benefit by having the option of reducing their generation and buying lower cost energy from the energy imbalance market to serve their load, and also by offering their generation into the marketplace for exposure to an increased customer base. Load serving entities benefit from more efficient competition among suppliers, which should lower the spot energy prices across the market footprint. This simple diagram demonstrates the interaction of the market participants and the market. With an EIM, the market operator is able to utilize geographic and resource diversity to optimize the dispatch of generation to serve the load in real time with the most economic unit dispatch within the transmission system constraint. This means that if you are an entity with high-cost resources, you will likely benefit by being able to access lower cost resources. And if you are an entity with lower cost resources, you will likely benefit from being able to run your resource at a higher capacity factor. One important aspect of an energy imbalance market construct is that the transmission utilized by the market operator to deliver energy from the lowest cost resources must be access to what the balancing authority needs and what has been reserved, and it must be available to deliver the energy to the load. In other words, the solution uses the lowest cost resource to serve deviations given the constraints on the system, maximizing generation availability and either avoiding or mitigating transmission constraints. Now we will walk through some examples demonstrating how an energy imbalance market works. This diagram shows what energy imbalance is. In this example, generator A was scheduled to provide 100 megawatt hours to load B. But in reality, generator A only provided 90 megawatt hours to load B, so there was a 10 megawatt hour of energy imbalance. This 10 megawatt hours of imbalance is what the energy imbalance market would solve for. Since, in this example, the load is less than what was scheduled, the load would be subject to energy imbalance charges. Next, we will go through an example of generation imbalance pricing using a bilateral transaction and the possible advantage of a EIM generation offer being utilized in the SCED real time, showing the increased efficiency of wide area economic dispatch. This example shows a bilateral transaction without an EIM. In this example, we can see that it costs generator 1 $40 per megawatt to generate up to 200 megawatts. Load 1 needs 100 megawatts, so generator 1 and load 1 enter a bilateral contract for generator 1 to provide 100 megawatts to load 1. Since a bilateral transaction is typically a negotiation between two parties, generator 1 and load 1 agree that the price will be 50 megawatts. The difference between what it cost generator 1 to produce the energy and what it sold the energy for is the profit for generator 1. So since generator 1 makes $10 per megawatt of profit and it sold 100 megawatts to load 1, its total profit in this transaction is $1,000. In this example, generator 2 does not have a contract with load 1 and no generation from generator 2 is dispatched. This slide illustrates a simple energy transaction in a bilateral market. It shows the most simplistic profit and loss calculations for an energy transaction between generator 1 and load 1. And we use this scenario for illustrative purposes only to show how we transact some of our energy scheduling today in a bilateral market. This example shows the same transaction, but it takes it a little bit further to show how it might operate in an energy imbalance market. It demonstrates how an energy imbalance market would dispatch the lowest cost resource to serve the load. In this scenario, both generator 1 and generator 2 offer their resources into the market, and there's still 100 megawatts of load at load 1. Also, generator 1 still has a bilateral contract to provide 100 megawatts to load 1. Due to the use of economic dispatch, the market determines what is the most efficient way to serve the 100 megawatts of load. And since the cost of generator 2 is much lower than generator 1, the market would dispatch generator 1 to its minimum generation amount of 5 megawatts, and then increase generator 2's output to 95 megawatts in order to serve the 100 megawatts of load. This example demonstrates how the EIM provides efficiencies from being able to utilize wide area economic dispatch and using the lowest cost resource to serve the 100 megawatts of load. Please remember, this example is extremely generic in nature and is not a resource for market strategies when entering any energy market. So this slide shows the financial side of the transaction we just discussed, and it demonstrates how each entity would benefit in an EIM market. As we mentioned, the bilateral contract between generator 1 and load 1 still exists. So load 1 pays generator 1 $50 per megawatt for 100 megawatt for a total of $5,000. In the market though, generator 2 can more economically serve this load. So the market dispatches generator 1 down to its minimum of 5 megawatts, and the market dispatches generator 2 to provide the rest of the generation to serve the 100 megawatts of load, or 95 megawatts. So although generator 1 was originally scheduled to provide 100 megawatts, it only actually provided 5 megawatts. Therefore, it must pay the market for the difference in actual versus scheduled generation at the market price, which in this case is $20. Generator 1 must pay $20 times the 95 megawatts it didn't supply, or $1,900 to the market. The market then in turn pays generator 2 $20 for the 95 megawatts it did provide, or $1,900. Although generator 1 had to pay because it delivered less energy to the market than it had scheduled, it still benefits from participating in the market in this scenario. The reason for this is that if generator 1 had provided all 100 megawatts of its own generation to load 1, it would have cost it $4,000 to generate that power at its production cost of $40 per megawatt, and it would have profited $1,000 because it would have sold this generation to load 1 for $50 per megawatt. In the market, generator 1 only produces 5 megawatts at $40 per megawatt, so its production cost is $200. Then, since its scheduled generation is different from its actual generation, it pays the market $1,900, as we mentioned. In total, it costs generator 1 the $200 production cost plus the $1,900 it must pay to the market for a total of $2,100 to serve the load at load 1. And since load 1 has paid generator 1 $5,000, generator 1's total profit is $2,900. This means that generator 1's profit is $1,900 more from participating in the market than the bilateral market. And generator 1 benefits $1,900 from being able to utilize a lower cost resource to serve the load it is obligated to serve. This is a very simple example of the energy imbalance market, and we did not delve into the many other possible advantages and aspects of an EIM, such as market redispatch for congestion management, joint tariff administration, financial settlements, and the unified settlements process. It should also be noted that the individual market products, business practices, and market applications offered by a particular EIM market may be dependent on the specific market and market operator and the depth in which each market participant participates. So although we have covered some basics of the construct itself, there may be some differences in the actual operation of each individual market.